Talking about slides. And demo and code to show is a bit hard, but I now just start talking before the demo, okay? Who needs pictures anyway? Okay, but a live demo without a monitor is a bit hard. I am... So I'm Anne Matthies. I'm coding Python since 1996, professionally, mostly closed source. And I remember switching to Python 2 in December 2000. That's why I'm no tolerance for legacy Python. So I switched to Python 3 completely in 2014. Which is a bit hard, but it's getting better, thanks God. I work at Bubble.com, the language learning thing, since 2010. It's a fast-growing company, and I'm responsible for the data platform there. So actually, I'm also, as you might see, PyData Berlin organizer and a data engineer and do data architecture. Mostly, I build data pipelines, so just the tooling for analysts and marketers and blah, blah, blah. And in a, well, growing company and a growing computer environment, those pipelines get messy very quickly. And my passion is to keep a grip on the mess, to just put everything into chunks and make it understandable for humans. Because the most complicated thing, no, not thing, the biggest issue in all running software that for more than a year are humans. I like them. But they surprise me every day. Again and again. So my focus in all this data architecture and data engineering thing is not only horizontal scaling and performance and so on. I call it organizational scaling, so that changing teams of human beings can understand what's going on. Because otherwise you have the most sophisticated, elegant, high-performing data pipeline setup. Yeah, the recruiter comes, hires someone off, and everything is gone. Or you fall in love and go crazy and no one understands. It's funny with that. So at Bubble, since 2013 actually, it started just with one production database. And then how it is, things were added and added and added and added. There's hope. And we were pretty successful in slicing those chunks and those code monoliths into single apps and services and tools. And we got more and more GitHub repos and more and more GitHub repos. Here that's they our, are. Good.
So let's try.
So now I need to... So... Monitor... And now? I just sync them. Good. Take the easy way out. Yeah, that's my favorite picture about humans. So everything is well organized, yeah? Finally, no more spaghetti code. Everything in micro chunks, and still it's how it is. So good. So our GitHub repos, they got more and 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 more. And when finally AWS, released Python 3.6 for AWS Lambda, it was clear that we need to do something to organize all this. Because, yeah, this is, yeah, so we have all infrastructure as code, yeah, it's all in CloudFormation templates created by Troposphere or Boto3, Boto Core directly. But then, how do you deploy those? Yeah? And then, normally, this is how it ends, because otherwise you need to write a tool that deploys your tool, that deploys your tool, that maintains your tool, and we know all this, right? And with AWS Lambda, and you think you do data, yeah? It's you needed to do something because it didn't really work. Also, analytics teams and other engineering teams then also come and say, can I access this? How can I access this? And we say, yeah, we've written a tool to access this easily for us data engineers, but not for those Ruby guys or the JavaScript people. They can code, they don't need a click tool, we don't do clickups, but Python for them, but their Jupyter notebooks and so on, so we had to do something. And we took all our micro chunks, which the Baukasten was sort of the library where we just lightweight abstraction layers to backends, Google, AWS, blah, 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 blah. But accessible easily for data engineers, and then we switched to packaging them, package, setup pi, and so on, for humans, human use cases, and also Conda installable. It's something I recommend if someone else, because every Ruby developer can do a Conda install, and they love it. So for use cases, and Marina, this give the packages a CLI. So instead of writing how we did before, another tool that then imports the other tools, that imports the other tools, we went for giving each component, each chunk, isolated chunk, just a CLI and a tiny, tiny app. We use Cliff for that, but you don't have to. Something is just convenient, so saves time. Whew, wrong direction. And then use entry points. And even if each package at least has this check command, that if you then tell someone, yeah, just run conda install blah, and then run blah check. They understand this. This is very easy, and you can read the code what it has to check. So even if it does nothing, use the entry point. And what comes now? Cliff, also we use Cliff, which is from OpenStack. The OpenStack tools I use Cliff is a framework for command line interface formulation framework. If you think this is too much overhead, the key is just that it loads entry points from package resources. I'm too lazy for this, I like Cliff, but this line is actually the most important thing you need if Cliff is too much. So now, finally, let's see what's still there. Yeah. show some code. So I wrote, I didn't bring internet here, it's horrible, and I don't want to show all the chunks that we have. So I wrote some tiny examples. Also we have, this is an app, hang on, I exit this presentation mode. This is on GitHub also, you can have a look. So I put this is what I put on GitHub. So I created two tiny apps, and just to show you this CLI thing, this is a stupid simple command. It just tells you that Klempner is installed. Yeah, so Klempner check. Can everyone see this? Klempner help. The help is something we really like, and which also makes this keeping grip of all those micro chunks a useful thing, because then you can add your Sphinx documentation and your doc strings, and they're just all there. The the crucial thing is the setup pi. That's all it needs that the check runs. Now comes some magic. Not here, hang on. We have, for example, our lambdas. Because lambdas, also you write lambda functions in Python 3, then you need to package them into zip files that are not bigger than 50 megabytes. These need to be deployed to S3 or something, and then your CloudFormation template must run the infrastructure and register them that they work all this in a team with permissions and changing code. So we wrote a very, very simple tool to just package those files and show which lambda functions we have. So that's normal, so several commands. The key point is this, that to the setup pi of our lambda app, we just add the Klempner, which Klempner is German for plumber, which does nothing but collecting all those packages if they are installed. So Klempner doesn't know anything about lambdas until lambdas is installed. Show you. So if I do Klempner help, here the commands are just check and help. Now I go to the, I'll show you. If I do lambdas, nothing happens. So now I do the pip. So now I do Klempner help, and it doesn't work. So hang on. So is lambdas installed? No. What did I do wrong? Hmm. It's the evil Bhima. I did this 7 times, so yes. So. Let's see, Lambda's help. Yeah, now it's there. Lambda help. Ah! Something is... It's not installed. It's because I'm in. Not A. Sorry for that. It's just a restart. So now, please. Nothing. Yeah. Okay, normally I think it's something in my mitochondria is activated. I have no idea. I did this even 10 minutes ago.
Sorry,
yeah. So what shall I type? What do you want to do it? But I did this, also even if it's it must be something else. It's M. Klempner.
Okay.
Thank you. Perfect. So, and now I can just do the Klempner lambdas show, for example, and it runs the commands that are definite. Just rehash things. I didn't know this. runs the commands in the other packages. And I just discovered this, this entry point magic via package resources this year. I love it, because all commands and documentation, the new version of Cliff, which I also maintain on Conda Forge, isn't deployed yet, because Travis has issues. But this even has much better Sphinx integration, that you could you write one simple Glue app that is only has the code. All it needs is this. And then you add this one entry point to all your other tiny apps, and you have them all at a command line together. And if you don't, then rehash. It's amazing. Must be with a restart, because normally we uninstall quite often, also the setup and pip uninstall. Yeah, sucks. And this is mainly it.
thanks, Anand, for a great talk and not so good circumstances. We have time for a quick question, or maybe two. Are there any questions? Oh, okay. No questions, then thank you again, and for lunch.
It's even downloading. That's a restart, because I rebooted my machine.